there's a connection. You think there's a connection that right here in Formula One, where life is devoted to the eradication of chance, to the elevation of science, you seriously think it can stroll arm in arm with Lady Luck. The roll of her dice, the luck of her draw. Come on. Oh, come on. You think this can in any way be linked with this? Except, you might say, there's the spin of the wheel. Oh, yes. Nice one. And that somebody somewhere is crossing their fingers, touching wood, hoping all goes well. Les jeux sont faits, monsieur dame. The chips are down, boys and girls. And you might say that if you want a backdrop of money, beauty, drama, adventure, style, speed and risk, if you want high living, fast living, then this is the name of the place. And this is the name of the game. They are connected. Just here, science and fiction, the jet set and the fast lane. Monte Carlo and Formula One, Monaco and Grand Prix. The two go together. Yeah, yeah. The Monaco Grand Prix.
Hey, our upgrade pace is looking solid right now, but I do think we need to push harder if we want to stay competitive. Here's the report.
Monaco for this weekend's Formula One Grand Prix. It's a race that is truly steeped in history, but before the drivers turn their attention to winning, they first need to get through today's tricky practice session. Lowe's hairpin is the slowest corner of any track on the Formula One calendar. It's taken at just 48 kilometers an hour, but provides a stunning view on the first lap as the entire grid bunches up and tiptoes through the corner, hoping not to leave any carbon fiber parts behind.
This is such a tight bend that a special steering rack is used just to get around this very corner, as the cars would not normally be able to make the turn. There is the possibility of overtaking through Lowe's, but more often than not, you'll end up damaging your car.
Okay, just want to remind you to keep an eye on your tyre usage. We have to give two sets back at the end of this session, so they'll be unavailable for the rest of the weekend. We'll hand over the two most worn sets, so don't ruin tyres you might want to use later. To remain dry for a while. We will update you if the outlook changes. Data. Return to base when you can so we can go over it. Once you're comfortable with the position through the corner, then start building up the speed. Practice program over. That's all we need for now. Return to the garage pronto.
Classification at the end of the session then, here are your top three, a Renault, Ricciardo and Nico Rosberg. That concludes an interesting practice session. Let's hope for more excitement as the weekend unfolds.
Hey. Looks like you've got a bit of rivalry going on out there. This is good. Gets people talking about you. Just make sure you outperform them, okay?
Hi, how are you? I'm just passing on your qualifying goals for this weekend.
One of the most difficult circuits on the racing calendar. Welcome to Monaco for today's Formula One qualifying. This has been an exciting track in times gone by, and typically it entertains the moment the lights go out.
It's the scene of many incidents as drivers jostle for position. You have to make a choice between going for it and self-preservation. There's no point in going in hot if you don't come out intact the other side. Even if you're at the front, you will be worrying about the guys behind you.
Okay, you should be able to get into the next qualifying session easily, so try to get a hot lap in early so we can save the tyres.
Is a 1:14.6. The excitement of qualifying, here's a look at your top three. A Renault, Verstappen and Lewis Hamilton. Goodbye for now then, but we're really just getting started. Make sure to join us again for Lights Out tomorrow.
Expectations for this race. Good luck.
Enjoy the moment. It's a very special time of the season once again, as we prepare for racing here this afternoon. There's no better test of driver, no more prestigious race to win, no bigger an occasion than the Monaco Grand Prix. The astonishing Circuit de Monaco is, for all intents and purposes, virtually unchanged since its inaugural race back in 1929. The faster cars of today, though, ensure the 19 corners past the casino and along the seafront remain as thrilling as ever. A 2.1-mile lap here takes us around an entire country, yet never more than inches from the race-ending barriers. Joining me to talk you through the action today is Anthony Davidson. And give us an idea of what kind of thing you're going to be looking out for today.
Well, the big question for me is whether or not we're going to see the cars able to follow each other closely enough to overtake, especially through the fast sections here. Of course, we've got DRS, and that will help on the straights, but it's still no good if you're coming off the previous corner too slowly or too far behind.
OK, it's a short run to Sandevort, and you know what Monaco's like, so try to defend this lead.
With that then, let's run through the grid order. It's Renault in pole position then, and Max Verstappen lines up alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Hamilton, Ricciardo, Fernando Alonso, and Rosberg, Wehrlein, Vettel, Button, and Jolyon Palmer, Bottas, Massa, Sergio Perez, and Harry Anto, Hülkenberg, Grosjean, Daniel Kvyat, and Kimi Raikkonen, Ericsson, and Gutierrez, Carlos Sainz, and Felipe Nasser starts from the back of the grid. And now, it's time to head down to the track. You got the feeling.
for a while. We will update you if the outlook changes.
Great job, mate. Another great, fantastic managed drive there.
That's what I'm talking about, guys. That's what I'm talking about.